Namaste, this is Swapnil from Helping Learning Platform. Today's discussion is about 10th schedule, that is anti-defection law. Firstly, why we are discussing about that schedule today? Today's in newspaper, Rebels Rajasthan MLA moves High Court against Speaker's notice. As far as UPSC is concerned, political parties and their issues is not at all important, but their provisions related to the particular article is highly important. What are schedules? Schedules are nothing but just like index page to the Constitution of India. There are 12 schedules in our Constitution, but today we are discussing about 10th schedule of the Constitution. Why means it is in the news article. Before moving into the 10th schedule, let us understand the historical evolution of the anti-defection law. Why it is created and when it is created. Since independence, Congress is the dominating power both in center as well as state. But this situation has shifted in early 1960s to single-party democracy to multi-party democracy. So, this multi-party democracy system paved way for 10th schedule. Let me explain this. In this multi-party democracy system, legislators are being elected on behalf of one party and then moving towards the other party after the election. So, to check this sort of situation, Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi in 1985 through 52nd Constitution Amendment Act incorporated 10th schedule in the Constitution of India. Moving on to the criteria of anti-defection law. Before moving into the criteria, firstly we need to understand what are the categories of legislature in our assembly. Firstly, they were elected members and then independent members and then nominated member. So now we look into it, how this anti-defection law applies to these different type of legislatures. Firstly, if any legislature voluntarily give up his membership, he comes under the ambit of anti-defection law. Here underlined word is voluntary. If it is involuntary in nature, they never comes under the ambit of anti-defection law. Next, come to the independent members. If independent members join any political party after the election, he comes under anti-defection law. And then come to the nominated members. If nominated members can join any political party within a 6 months after the election, they comes under ambit of anti-defection law. So now we look into what are the advantages of this anti-defection law. Firstly, it maintains stability in the government. And it also strengthens our democracy by checking unethical principles. And it also reduces corruptions at the political level, such as we already come across n number of times, that is horse trading. And then disadvantages of anti-defection law. Firstly, ruling political party using these provision to their whims and fancies. And this law doesn't differentiate between what is dissent and what is defection. And it also showing discrimination between independent and nominated members. However, like any other legislation, even the anti-defection law is attracted with the negativities. To cleanse this, there are three committee recommendations. Before we enter into the recommendations, we need to understand one particular exception in this anti-defection law, that is merger clause. That is, if 2/3 members of any political party moves from one party to another party, this is called merger. This merger clause doesn't come under the ambit of anti-defection law. Here, next, Dinesh Goswami committee recommendation. What is Dinesh Goswami recommendation? He recommended that this merger clause should be removed. And then next commission, law commission. Law Commission recommended that pre-poll alliance should be treated as a one single party if after the pre-poll elections. Secondly, Law Commission recommendation. It recommended pre-poll alliance should be treated as one political party. And then finally, Election Commission recommendations. As per the original provision of anti-defection law, the final authority is Speaker. But Election Commission recommended that final authority should be decided by the President or Governor. For write-up regarding this article, visit to our website www.helpinlearning.com. Thank you.